Jordan, what's in this box?
This is the brand new Oris 17. Alder Lake is what we're going to see in here. This particular model, I'm told, is not quite going to be the one that's going to be sold in the U.S. Because it has a one notch lower CPU than they're going to sell in the U.S., the i7. But the U.S. will get the i9 version, but still, it's worth looking at because it is a new design. Apparently, Oris 17 is, of course, a big gaming laptop. As the name implies, 17.3-inch screen. Okay, got it. I always like to check out the power brick. For power supply, this is usually the tell. It is a 240-watt power supply. Pretty decent, fairly compact, because sometimes they can get very big and fat. 240 watts. Let's pull it out. What do you got? Paper, probably warranty stuff, no other surprises. Okay. So what they're saying with the new Oris 17 is it is basically like a 17.3-inch gaming laptop that's in the size of about a 15-inch laptop. And so this is actually a fairly compact 15.6-inch laptop. If this were a typical 16.9 gaming laptop, it'd probably be a little bit thicker, a little bit wider, but maybe. Let's look at the impact once we open it up, though, because the screen. Now, we get a camera. There is a Windows Hello camera. You also see the holes for the speaker near field, but it's got a notch, is that an anti-notch? I don't know what we're calling these.
A nega notch.
Is it nega notch?
No,
I don't know. But you know, this is a 17.3-inch screen laptop versus a 15. Let's see how it looks. It's close. I mean, it might fool a few people. This is no XPS 17. That actually is about the same size as a 15.6-inch 16:9 aspect ratio. This is 16:9 as well, 17.3-inch IPS, like 360 hertz, 3-millisecond response spec. Well, let's go over the ports then. So you get your barrel charger for your 240-watt charger, Thunderbolt C, USB. Is it properly labeled? It's super speed, so that could be everything from 10 gig to 20 gig. I'm going to guess it's a 10 gig port. Could even be 5 gig, who knows. We get your combo, analog, headset jack. Nothing on the back, although I do like the little orange accents. That's pretty nice.
Just a little something.
It is heat pipes, no thermal chamber. I think there's 5 heat pipes, 2 fans. This side, we are getting HDMI, mini display port, another USB-A port, probably 10 gig, I'm guessing. I don't know what this Ethernet port is, whether it's gigabit or 2.5. I will check, mention it later. But let me fire this thing up. We'll look at what is inside. I got a couple of specs I've been meaning to point out to people. I wasn't able to find out what the Ethernet port was on their website, but it is a 2.5 gigabit Realtek controller for there for people who care about their NICs. We know who you are. Also for Wi-Fi, it is an Intel Wi-Fi 6E AX211 part for Wi-Fi 6E. Other specs that you care about are the GPU and CPU. This is Intel's Core i7-12700H. As you can see, it's got the same core count as a Core i9-12900HK, as well as the other Core i9 and Core i7 chips out there. The big difference between the Core i7-12700H and the Core i9-12900HK is simply boost on performance and efficiency cores, about a 300 megahertz difference on performance and efficiency cores. That adds up to maybe 6% difference on your boost clocks. Not a huge deal, actually. I think actually this is fine. For GPU though, it's very impressive. They have stuff, the NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3080 Ti. That's basically a 3080 with 20% more of everything. That's 20% more CUDA cores, 20% more ray tracing cores, 20% more tensor cores. It's just 20% add-on. One Thing you need to note though is they're going, wow, you put a 3080 in here? Because look how thin this is. This is actually a legitimately very thin, fairly compact laptop, and Gigabyte is able to do that because, you know what, we give you a 3080 Ti, but we are not going to crank the clocks up. We are not going to crank the wattage up. The part in here is 130 watt TGP GPU. That includes 15 watts in Dynamic Boost 2.0. So you can kind of think of it as 105 watt GeForce 3080 Ti versus what you would see in a thicker, more powerful laptop like the MSI GE76 Raider that most of the Alder Lake coverage came out at. That laptop is fairly thin for what it is, but it is definitely thicker than this Aorus 17. Also, it has a bigger power supply. That's also the tell. That thing had a 330 watt power supply. This is 240 watts. So 175 watt 3080 Ti, 130 watt 3080 Ti. That 40 watts means smaller power brick. Also, should be mentioned, this panel, 17.3 inch, 16.9 IPS-like, 360 hertz. Very much to me, a gaming panel in what I would sort of think is almost like a content creation creator body. This doesn't really scream to me pure gamer, but a 3080 Ti and 360 hertz screen panel screams to me that it is a gaming laptop. So I'm a little confused, even more confused. This laptop came with the studio drivers. I would have expected it to come with game ready drivers, but I think it's just sort of that slippery slope of what is a creator now. Creator is video editor. For older people like me, that's a video editor. That's what we think Adam is. He's a creator, works in Premiere all day. I think the laptop companies are seeing creators like, I play games all day, record it, and then I edit the video on my laptop. So maybe that's what a creator is turning into from laptop makers these days. Okay, what else do we need to know? 99 watt hour battery. We went over the ports, we went over the power supply. You want to know how it's going to perform, because I'm interested, because I've not seen a 12700H myself, or a 3080 Ti at 130 watts. I've only seen them at 175 watts, and I've also only seen the Core i9 myself. So we're going to run a couple quick benchmarks just to whet your appetite. This is not a review. This is not a review. So if you're going to go down there and type, oh, great review, or you should have mentioned this in your review, this is just simply a frame of reference to help you feel where this laptop's going to come in at. So check back. I'm going to run some tests. We're going to give you that idea in a second. Hey, so we're back. Just finished running a few quick tests on this Gigabyte Aorus 17. Again, this is not a review. I'm just going to run a few benchmarks to give you an idea of where this laptop's going to fall when we're finished reviewing it, which you can read on PCWorld.com once it's written. But right now, let's talk about the performance. First up, Maxon Cinebench R20. This is a 3D rendering benchmark. More cores are better. More cores gives you more bars, longer bars. And you can see the Aorus 17 with its 14-core Core i7 doing really well. Again, the top is the MSI GE76 Raider. Very fast, definitely thicker laptop, more power supply. That's right at the tippy top with 7005. The Aorus 17, depending on which performance setting you pick, will give you everywhere from 5676 in Cinebench to 6100. I'm actually seeing 6300 with its AI mode. If you select that, it bounces around a little bit more than I would expect, but there are so many different buttons you can push on this laptop in a control panel that may be the big decider. But 14 cores of 12th gen Alder Lake is nothing to mess with, even in the Core i7, which is lower than a Core i9 and Ryzen 9. It's going to be a force to be reckoned with. At the top end, that's all core. Single-threaded loads, though, are what probably a lot of people care about, because that's Photoshop, that's sort of Chrome, that's Word. That's where a lot of the boring stuff lands, single-threaded area. And we can, again, see the Core i7-12700H doing really good. Core i9 gets you the highest boost, especially single-threaded boost. But, you know, there's an argument to be made that Core i9 probably isn't worth it for a lot of people. And you can sort of see that here where the Core i7 in this Aura 17, it's not as fast as that Core i9-12900HK, but is it that much slower? I would say no. And single-threaded, in fact, it's pretty much, you know, among the fastest we're seeing. It's definitely faster than everything we're seeing from AMD so far, although impressively that Zephyrus G14, that new Ryzen 6000 part, is up there, especially when set to turbo. But in this Aura 17, even in the default mode or in its AI or its turbo mode, it's moving along pretty fast. Almost as fast as that Core i9. Not quite as fast, but for a lot of people, probably plenty of performance. Of course, the really big question, though, is what happens when you take a 3080 Ti and you limit it to 130 watt TGP instead of 175 or 165 watts that we're seeing in some laptops. Remember, 3080 Ti is basically 3080 with 20% more added to it. 3080 Ti with 175 watts is moving nice and fast in that MSI GE76 Raider at the top. You're seeing that. big power supply, bigger laptop at 6.4 pounds, 13,506. This is not bad though, pretty good at 11,994 when set to turbo, and the default mode was 11,658. So 3080 Ti is very nice. But let's also look at some of the other laptop GPUs here. You're looking at that Zephyrus S17. It has an older 11th gen Core i9 in there. But the RTX 3080 is at 140 watts and 10,840, really good. But the 3080 Ti, even with a little less TGP, is still ahead of it at 11, you know, almost 12,000 to 11,600. So very decent. There are definitely some 3080s as you get down to the 100 watt TGP, where in the very thin, very small laptops, it's kind of getting hard to justify that 3080 in a thin and light laptop, because the performance is very close to what you're seeing out of 3070s. AMD's new Radeon RX 6800S, in fact, will do battle with a 100 watt 3080. So you may want to think about 3080 in a very small, very thin laptop. Finally, the last performance benchmark we're going to show off is 3DMark Port Royal. This is a ray tracing benchmark, pure ray tracing test, originally created when the original RTX came out. Top end, again, is that great big fat RTX 3080 Ti in the GE76 8427. Step the wattage down to 130 watts from 175 watts, and we drop down to about 7,500, 7,495 to be exact, which isn't bad. You know, that's looking at about 12% difference from 175 watt TGP, better cooled laptop versus 130 watts. I would say that's a very decent trade-off. And again, you take that 3080, depending on what you put it into, how much cooling you can give it, how much power you can feed it, it scales everywhere from like, why didn't you just get a 3070 into, wow, that's actually pretty fast. So if you look at AMD's Radeon RX 6800 in the M, which is a thicker laptop, more power, it's a very competitive part with the 3080. And the 6800S in much thinner laptop, also fairly competitive for what you're getting in Port Royal. Of course, this is a ray tracing benchmark that's going to favor NVIDIA parts generally, because they are generally built for better ray tracing performance, hardware ray tracing performance, unless you're talking about that new GeForce RTX 3050 Ti and 3050. I don't know what's up with that part, but it really underperforms. When you look at the previous results in 3DMark Time Spy, in most games, it's not bad, but you get to the ray tracing performance and it gets all kinds of ugly. I don't know what's going on. 1,042 for something that is an RTX 3050 Ti. When you look at a 3060, an RTX 3060 at 4158, you're like, what's up with that? 3050 Ti to 3060, that is a huge drop off in performance. I was kind of wondering what was going on, but looking around, other reviewers have also seen this 3050 Ti just does not seem to be a fantastic ray tracing part. The good thing is you still get DLSS, and you're also still going to get the NV encode, which is probably what you want it for. So I wouldn't freak out about that, but I would like, definitely for ray tracing, I wouldn't expect the world. But of course, we're talking about 3080 Ti, and 3080 Ti in this Aorus 17 looking pretty nice. And I do want to say one thing that is worth pointing out with it is it's actually fairly quiet. This room isn't the best for making audio judgments, but just simply using my ears and listening to this laptop under load in its AI performance mode, it's relatively quiet. It's not horrible. I'm not saying it's fanless. But there's a difference between fan at 100% and reasonably quiet gaming performance of a laptop. So I will say it does pretty well. And part of that is, you know, Gigabyte saying, hey, we're going to keep it to 130 watts. You go to 175 watts, you run the fans at maximum. That's kind of a different ballpark. If you just simply want, you know, really good gaming with moderate fan noise, this is not a bad option. And I also want to show this control center. Gigabyte has been pushing AI-based performance in his laptops for a while. They basically will go to, they say it's accelerated by Microsoft Azure AI. Basically, they use AI in the cloud to sort of help set performance thresholds for the laptop. Whether that has worked or not in the past, I wouldn't say it hasn't, but it looks like it's just gotten a lot better here, because we, with AI on this laptop, the performance is pretty decent. In fact, I'm seeing the performance in AI mode somewhat faster than turbo mode, which shuts off the AI mode and sort of cranks the fans up to a higher RPM than it would under AI. So there is, it's starting to finally come together for Gigabyte with this. So overall, Aorus 17 looking pretty good. It's reasonably thin, 6 pounds. Unfortunately, I don't have the price of this laptop yet. Hopefully we'll get that soon, but I'm going to guess with a 3080 Ti, and also in the US side, it will be sold with a Core i9, not a Core i7. I'm going to guess it's going to be north of $3,000, because you don't get a 3080 Ti into low budget laptops, at least not yet. Also, I really will never understand this power plug on the right side, except that I'm going to guess everybody at Gigabyte who's in control must be left-handed, because it kind of bugs me that you plug it in here. Most of the laptops either going back or the left side, but apparently Gigabyte is saying, hey, we're all lefties. So head over to PCWorld.com to read the review of this laptop when it's done, and like and subscribe PC World's YouTube channel right down there.